President Trump verbally sparring with Arizona Senator Jeff Flake, their feud intensifying as the race heats up for Flake's seat in the 2018 midterm elections. The president even encouraging competitors to seek Flake's seat. Flake responded by saying Trump could face a primary challenger himself in 2020. Joining me right now is Dr. Kelli Ward, former Republican Arizona State Senator and current GOP primary challenger for Senator Flake's Arizona seat. Good to see you, Kelli. Thanks very much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Maria. We certainly are all praying for the people of Texas.
Yes, we are, and we've got that covered. We're going to go back as news develops there. But Dr. Ward, give us your qualifications, why you believe you should have that Senate seat. Make the case.
Well, I'll tell you, Maria, I was a very effective Arizona State Senator. I got things done through the legislative process. I was able to put forth excellent policy ideas, get buy-in from both sides of the aisle, and then get it through the sometimes complicated process and get it to the executive's desk. People saw that success in Arizona, and they want me to take that to Washington. They're sick and tired of the do-nothing Congress and Senate, especially the Senate. So I look forward to getting there and getting things done.
What's the problem, though? I mean, when you look at what has just taken place in terms of health care, that the Senate, they didn't even look at the House's version of the health care bill. You've got massive divisiveness within the Senate about President Trump's policies. If you didn't, you would have seen more get done. What do you think needs to happen to bring people together?
I definitely think in 2018 we need to elect people who have that America First agenda in mind. People who want to secure the border, who want to stop illegal immigration, who want to repeal Obamacare finally, who want to keep the economy growing, who want to fix the tax code and want to make sure that our military is the strongest in the world. Unfortunately, we have a lot of people in Washington, especially in the Senate, who like to talk a lot but don't like to get a lot of things done and haven't been able to collaborate with each other, House to Senate, within the Republican Party to accomplish the agenda that the American people are crying out for.
What does the president need to do in terms of his own leadership to govern in terms of getting some legislative victories? We were just talking with Jason Chaffetz. They only have the Congress a couple of days left when they get back from their summer recess in order to get big things done like tax reform. Is it doable?
Mm-hmm. You know, I think it's going to be a big challenge because our government is set up to be incremental and have incremental change. But if they aren't in Washington, D.C., putting their noses to the grindstone and getting things done, it's going to be very difficult. I think the president and his leadership will go a long way if we can get the leader in the House and the leader in the Senate to come together and accomplish those goals that America wants.
What have you done in terms of getting the votes, in terms of getting the support from within your own party? I mean, we see Jeff Flake out has a very contemptuous relationship with President Trump. What's your thought in terms of how this plays out?
Right. You know, I think that Senator Flake is going in the exact wrong direction, attacking the president at every turn. But remember, he's been a never-Trumper since the primary. He wasn't for Trump during the primary. He wasn't for the president after he became the nominee. And he certainly hasn't been for the president since he's been in the White House. The polls are showing I'm up by double digits on Senator Flake. I want to work with the people in Washington, D.C., as well as the people across this country to accomplish the goals that are set before us to make this country great again.
I just want to point out that Senator Flake has said that if the president keeps up his behavior, quote unquote, he's going to face a challenger from the Republican Party in 2020. And then, of course, we also hear rumors that John Kasich is going to hook up with Governor Hickenlooper and be a camp and have their own campaign going into 2020. Do you think the Republican Party will produce a competitor to President Trump in 2020?
I certainly think that would be a big mistake for the establishment wing of the Republican Party to attempt. I think President Trump and his leadership is what the country wanted. That's why he's in the White House, and I think that he's got lofty goals that we should accomplish that will put America first.
All right. Dr. Kelli Ward, we appreciate you coming on this morning. We hope you'll come back soon. We'll be watching the developments. Thank you.
Thanks, Maria.
And by the way, John Kasich said, no, okay? That was his quote when asked if in fact, he was ready to run for president in 2020. This morning on one of the Sunday shows, no, okay? And that was his answer.